I'm John Wee.
And I'm Owen Morse, and we are called The Passing Zone.
And, you know, we do a comedy and juggling act, basically.
Yeah, kind of it.
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah.
It's mostly, sometimes it's comedy. And
then about the other half, it's the juggling part.
The juggling comes in. We're probably practicing these days about, you know, 3 or 4 days a week for about 3 hours a day, that sort of thing.
Yeah, and about half of that is working on things that are already in the show, and then half is about learning new skills and new routines.
We're also traveling and working a lot. So when we're on the road, then sometimes, you know, a lot of time goes by, a week or so, where we don't practice at all. So when we get home, it's time to get back to the practice space. Not very much. I mean, I do just, you know, basic stretching out. Not very much. Someone who knows about stretching would be ashamed to see what I do. It's not good.
And we do warm up with solo juggling and, you know, get ourselves limbered up a little bit. And then we go into passing clubs. And we have a fairly regimented club passing segment that we do.
Yeah. Our normal club practice is we start just passing six, and we do that for a pretty long time with a lot of variations and things like that, and then run through the routine in the show a few times with the six clubs. Then we add seven, and we do a bunch of variations with those that are not in the show either.
Yeah, and probably never will be, but they're fun for us.
Yeah.
Then we go to eight.
Seven back to back.
Yeah. And eight singles, doubles, triples, back down to singles, and then eight back to back.
And that's with triples back to back with eight. Yeah, and then we do nine, and we run nine a bunch of times.
And nine back-to-back with triples.
And then usually, if things are feeling good, we'll do 10 a little bit.
Yeah.
And that usually consists of, you know, a couple of successful runs out of maybe a dozen tries or so. You know, we're not hitting it all the time, but we're still getting it pretty much every day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Common thing to learn a new trick is just to break it down and just do one throw of it, or, you know, just find the lowest common denominator of what that trick is and work on that and add to it.
Add something and work on, you know, depending on what it is. I mean, there's so many different tricks that require different kinds of practice. But, you know, if you're working on combination tricks, well, then, you know, combine two of the things instead of all three or four.
Yeah.
Or then combine a different combination of two or three instead of doing them all. And sometimes it's just a matter of doing something that's convenient enough. You know, if you're on a tall unicycle or something, you know, practice all the stuff off the unicycle first so you don't have to drop and get off the unicycle every time.
And it's handy to have a partner so that the other guy can, you know, help you out.
Yeah.
For us, the trick is never ready for the show, but we put it in anyway.
Yep. And it's a combination of things. One, you have to feel just as secure as you possibly can with the physicality of the trick in practice.
Yeah.
You know, the trick has to work pretty much every time. But as far as the jokes and the routines and all of the ideas, we often go in with sort of a half-baked idea or something where we say, how about you say something like this, I'll say something like this.
Right.
We'll see where it goes. You know, we sort of get it about half ready.
Yeah, we sort of know what to say, but not how to say it. And that kind of leads you into it, and you can kind of flesh out the routine and find out what the audience thinks is funny and then build on that.
Depends on the show also. Some shows are higher pressure and you really have to stick to the good stuff and, you know, not try your new things. But some audiences, you can, it's a lot more loose and you can try some new things that way.
Practice advice for young jugglers.
Practice, practice, practice.
Yeah, practice. Try practicing the right thing. I mean, and you can go on YouTube and you can watch plenty of videos of guys doing it right. Emulate jugglers like Anthony Gatto. I mean, it's just brilliant and perfect.
Jason Garfield also has a book and some great tips on how to practice correctly.
Yeah.
I would say that if those things were around when I learned how to juggle, I'd probably be a lot better by now.
We're trial and error.
We did not learn correctly. Study those kind of things. And
you know, get your phone out and videotape yourself.
See,
video yourself. Good grief, that's how old I am.
And then
watch it. You know, don't just do it and don't watch it, but see and slow it down. See if you're making some odd catches or the angles of your clubs or whatever your prop is off. And compare it to other videos that you see on YouTube.
Try to practice efficiently, not just trying the same mistake over and over and over and over and over again until someday it gets right. You know, try to figure out why it's wrong and try to correct it as soon as you can.
Yeah, identify that mistake. Don't just, you know, question why something went wrong.
And the same is true with performing. You know, when you perform a lot, then it's just trying things over and over again. It's not going to maybe be at its best the first time you perform it.
Right.
But you do it over and over, and maybe by the 10th time, it'll be getting pretty good.
can reach us online. Our website is passingzone.com.
And we're also on Facebook at The Passing Zone and Twitter at The Passing Zone. And we do a little bit of Instagram here and there for at The Passing Zone also.
Yeah.
So there you could call us on our cell phones.
We're going to give you John's cell phone.
Well, we'll get around to that later.
Yeah.
But, thanks so much, guys.
All right. Hey. Our pleasure.
Thank you.
Thanks very much.